pressure on your neck. Yeah, the kind you get when you start to feel that you can connect to the words of my rhyme. As you listen one at a time, they begin to take shape and bring an image into your mind. One that helps you to see, cause in this world there's so many lies and so many people living in a phony disguise. So now I'm here to help you out and bring about your decline by giving you a rhyme that leaves you with a tingle in spine. That reacts in your head, you wake up watching like it was dead. So you can save it for your minute. Repeat what I said. To stop the media money makers that ruin society. The ones who try to put a stop to lyrical sobriety. Yeah, and now there's so many complications, and many people now are screwed up situations. Because of what we love, walk into our lives, so it gets in the eyes, and yet we all surprised.
Come on, man.
What about the kids?
No, the kids.
Don't you dare call them kids. Those are not kids. Those are little animals, man. No. I can't do it.
Sure you can.
No, look. I don't even want you to pay me to teach them. All right? No.
I can't pay you, but I would if I could.
Listen. That one with the attitude, man, I can't deal with him. Well, I'm not here for that, okay? One of them keeps farting. No, I got to get out of here, man. I can't do this, man.
Wait. What about the tournament? You can't quit now.
Charlie, watch me.
What? Now what?
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yes, thank you. Next.
Inspiring.
Yeah. Thank you.
Impressive.
Next.
Great balls of fire.
You gotta keep your chin down.
What?
I said you gotta keep your chin down.
Excuse me, mister, but I believe you're disturbing our concentration.
Wait, let him speak.
Yes, let him speak.
So what do you know about karate?
A little.
Like what?
I know that if you keep your chin down, you won't lose balance.
And how do you know that?
I just know.
Pusha. Are you here for an audition?
No.
Can you show us?
Maybe some other time.
I knew it. All talk and no action.
Okay, I'll show you. So who wants to hold the pad?
Yes.
Okay. Hold it up.
You came. You're all back together again. Look at you.
Charlie, how come you're limping?
It's just a chip. I'm just getting old, you know? It's nothing. It warms up. Hey, listen, did you eat?
No, not yet.
I gotta take you someplace.
Oh, yeah? Where are you taking me, Charlie?
Hey, Big Mama.
Hey, Charlie!
I brought you a surprise.
Well, for heaven's sake!
Hey, Big Mama, how you doing?
Boy, we have not seen you in this neck of the woods for a long time. Last time I heard, you hit it big. Then it hit me that you got hit by a bus or something?
Semi.
A what?
A big truck.
Semi-big truck. What do I know, Charlie? I just heard you got hurt really bad. So tell me, Jimmy, are you coming home for good or are you just visiting?
No, I'm just visiting.
Jimmy's training for his big fight.
What? Boy, are you gonna fight again after all that? Are you crazy?
Can't give up now. Besides, it's the only thing that I'm good at.
Well, if you're gonna fight, you gotta eat. So what can I get for you, sugar?
Charlie?
Get the special.
Special?
You got the special, Charlie.
I'll have my Hebrew.
Your Hebrew dog. You know good and well your money is no good here. Now you put that back in your pocket. That's on me. All right, give me a special and a Hebrew dog for my Charlie.
This is a bad idea.
Why do you keep saying that?
Because I hate kids, Charlie. They smell and they're a pain in the butt.
Just give it a chance, okay?
Hey, kid, gather up here. I want you to meet the former mixed martial arts champion of the world,
Jimmy the Lightning Bolt, your new coach.
I bet a dollar you won't last 1 week.
I'll give him 2 weeks, tops. Hi, kid.
Hi, Valerie.
Hi, Charlie. How was class today?
Being half class today.
You still couldn't find a teacher?
No, I found a replacement. Meet Jimmy. Jimmy, this is Valerie. Valerie is Sean and Alex's aunt.
How you doing?
Hi.
Nice meeting you.
Pleasure.
Auntie, this is Jimmy the Lightning Bolt.
Jimmy the Lightning Bolt?
Isn't he awesome? Look at him. Look at his jacket.
He's a former MMA champion.
Oh, a former MMA champ, huh? Kids, go get ready, okay? Charlie, can I have a word with you? Would you excuse us for a moment?
Sure.
Are you kidding me? An MMA champ named Lightning Bolt? Are you crazy, Charlie? And who names their kid Lightning Bolt?
Well, when Jimmy was a kid, he was struck by lightning. And he lived. That's how he got his name. And he is a great guy when you get to know him. Valerie, Jimmy is like a son to me. And I trust him with my life.
Jimmy the Lightning Bolt. An orphan boy grows up to become an MMA champion. That's what Charlie meant. He doesn't have any family. Jimmy the Lightning Bolt hospitalized. Saves a 5-year-old boy from a runaway truck. Champ may never be able to fight again. Career ruined.
Listen, you've been out of the fight circuit for over 3 years, and fight years are like dog years.
Well, I was in a little accident, remember?
Yeah. Everybody remembers, which is why nobody wants to insure you.
Look, Gino, I sign a waiver, okay? I'll do anything. Just get me back into the cage, all right?
Jimmy, you're not getting any younger.
What did you say?
Okay, you know, I may have something in the meantime, all right? The Shapiro Bar Mitzvah.
This is a sweet gig, too. All you do, you
dress up like a ninja. About halfway through the ceremony, you drop out of the ceiling, you go up on stage, you fight this kid. And believe me, he's not a big kid. So it pays $500, but the kid does get to beat you up.
I'm going to pretend like I didn't hear that.
All right. Trying.
Gino, just give me a fight, will ya?
I'll try.
What if I made it so you could beat up the kid and then... Okay, forget it.
Excuse me, Mr. Lee?
What?
Aren't you gonna teach us?
So what do you want to do?
Maybe we can start with some punching drills?
Why do we have to start with punching drills?
Okay, you guys want to do blocks?
Man, blocking is for the birds. Why don't we just go right into sparring?
Not a good idea.
It is a known fact that without proper sparring equipment, one can get seriously injured, maimed, or knocked unconscious.
Man, you're just scared and you know it.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Not.
Then back it up!
Hey. Break it up. From now on, I will lead and you will follow. No questions, no objections. You got that?
Hey, Alex, what's an objection?
That's what lawyers always say to the judge.
Quiet! Get back in line. If you guys keep talking, I'm gonna give you guys 10 push-ups on your knuckles.
On our knuckles? Man, that's BS!
Okay, everybody go down 10.
Forget this. I quit.
You wanna quit? Quit.
And I hate this class already.
Well, that's good, because I don't like you either.
You're me!
And you're short. Go eat some Cheerios. Where's Raymond? Raymond! Get your butt over here! All of you, line up. Let's go. What is this?
Just a snack.
Just a snack? Oh, boy. Okay, you guys. Rally back fighting stance. You guys do know fighting stance, yes? Rally back, hands up to the side. Here we go. Give me some kyo. One! Again. Is that the best you guys could do?
It's the sound of karate.
Oh boy. What did I get myself into?
Three and one. Ha! Yes! Ha! Yes! Ha! 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 Ha!
You see how I executed that technique? It's flawless. Speed, power, technique, and timing is everything in competition karate. Does everyone understand?
Yes, sir!
Does everyone understand?
Yes, sir!
Take a break. Freeze. Eric.
Yes, Dad. Yes, sir.
What are you doing?
Helping an opponent is a sign of weakness. Never do it again.
Yes, sir.
Dismissed.
Always gotta do that.
What?
I mean, can't we just buy it at the theater?
$20 for a bucket of popcorn? I don't think so. Plus, mine is way better.
And I'm not going.
Why?
It's embarrassing.
Honey, nobody's gonna even know.
I don't know.
So what? You wanna just sit around and mope all day, or you wanna go to the movies?
I already told you. I'm not going.
Wyatt?
would want to. She saw a building with a YMCA sign on it.
What?
They spelled Macy's wrong.
You and your dumb blonde jokes.
Alex, do you ever miss Mom and Dad?
Yeah.
Me too.
Time to brush your teeth.
I hate brushing my teeth.
I hate brushing my teeth. If you don't brush your teeth, they're gonna start falling out of your mouth.
Is that why you put that green stuff on your face so your face won't fall off, huh?
Oh, you think you're so funny. I'm gonna chistosito. Oh, payasito, que me asustes. Yeah, chistosito.
Oh, you want some too?
Here comes the green monster.
Boy, for heaven's sake.
That's a problem. He's growing sideways.
That was mean and uncalled for, Ron.
That's okay, Mom. I'm really not that hungry.
So, did you go to a karate class today?
Yes, sir.
Did you sweat?
Yes, sir.
Good. Because if you don't sweat, you're never going to lose any weight. And when you're fat, people will treat you differently.
Don't listen to your dad. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
There you go, always protecting him. No, you're the reason he's so fat, Martha. You baby him too much.
Ron!
What?
I'm sorry, Mom.
Don't be sorry. Be strong.
Here we go. One.
Come on, Raymond.
Two. Three. Four.
Raymond, you're disgusting.
It wasn't me, I swear.
Sure.
All right, so what? I farted as if you never fart.
Girls don't fart. My auntie farts.
No, she doesn't.
Yes, she does.
You guys, everybody get up. Make one single line. Raymond, don't you ever do that again. Everybody get your hands up. Four. One. You're late. If you're going to be in my class, you can't be late.
I don't want to be in your stinking class. So just get out of my face.
What did you say?
You heard me.
What happened?
I don't want to talk about it.
Don't tell me you ran into a door.
That ain't funny.
I'm not laughing. Now, what happened?
There's this big guy. He wanted me to sell something for him. And when I said no, he beat me up.
Where's this guy?
It's them.
Hey!
What are you, back for more?
Did you do this to him?
No. I did.
You?
This little baby brought his nanny.
I thought you told me that a big guy beat you up.
I did. His name is Big Guy.
I'm out of here.
Bye, little chicken butt.
Think you're funny, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, look at that! Come on, let's get out of here.
Come back here, you chicken butt! Fight me like a real man instead of pulling my pants down!
Coach?
Yeah. kids.
Give me a second.
Take him out.
I hear you were messing with my brother out there.
Asshole.
So nobody hits my brother and gets away with it.
I'll tell you what. If you beat me, I'll do anything you say. But if I beat you, in fact, if I beat all of you, you'll do what I say. Fair?
Who do you think you are, Superman?
I'm just his nanny. Right? Sorry. Kids, I want you to close your eyes. Potential. You need to make a choice.
You want to take someone out? You gotta do it yourself.
Everybody, you all know about this tournament's coming up in 2 weeks. I think this would be a good opportunity for all of you to participate.
What are you doing here, Ricky?
I came to apologize.
For what?
My behavior.
And?
I won't quit.
Harry?
You made a good choice, son.
Thank you, sir.
Wyatt?
Dude, I'm sorry.
It's all right, man.
Thank you. Thank you all for being here. Today, we appreciate it so much. As a proud sponsor of this year's tournament, we at Champions R Us want you to know that we are dedicated to building a bright future for all our children. And now, I hope that you will join in with me in a nice big round of applause for the three-time All-City Junior National Champions, the Beverly Hills Scorpions.
This is your first tournament, so I want you to work really hard and use your hands a lot. Use strategy.
Jimmy Lee! I hadn't heard that voice in a long time. I thought it was you.
Ted Barrett, how's it going?
Great. Just great. I look good. The team's undefeated champions, 3 years running. Life couldn't be sweeter. I'm sorry. How about you?
I can't complain.
Really? Well, that's funny, because I thought I heard a nasty rumor that you can't even get a fight. Now, that couldn't be true, could it?
You know, you haven't changed since we were little kids, you know that?
What we got here?
This is my team. Kids, say hello to Mr. Ted Barrett.
Ted Barrett? The undefeated world karate champion?
That's right. You're looking at him.
Can I have your autograph?
Well, now, if I gave you my autograph, I'd have to give it to everybody, wouldn't I? But you're in luck. I've got some pre-signed 8x10s right back there for only $10.
$10? That's ridiculous.
Did I tell you I started my own line of workout wear? Here you go. You just hand them this. And they'll give you a 2% discount each and every time.
A whopping 2%? Barry, that's very generous of you.
Hey, what are friends for? Really, Jimmy, good to run into you. And honestly, best of luck.
Good seeing you, Barry. Kids, come on.
What an idiot. What'd you say?
You didn't say anything. Ricky, you've got to watch your mouth.
Kids really suck.
Bye, you guys.
Bye.
Good job. Hey, Gino. It's me. So what's the good news?
So far, a whole lot of nothing, but I'm working on it, buddy.
Nothing? Gino, I gotta get back in the ring. Otherwise, I'll be stuck with these kids forever. And I'm running out of money.
Well, if you need some cash right now, maybe I could book you at the Johnson Sisters bachelorette party. It's a good gig. All you gotta do is dress up like Bruce Lee in a Speedo, but it's $200, and if you're super nice, you can make a buttload of tips. I like this job. It's good.
Just give me a fight, will ya?
All right, suit yourself.
You gotta get me out of here soon. I'm getting desperate.
Listen, pal. When I get you a fight, I'll call you back.
Mr. Lee, what do you think?
You missed a spot.
Okay, no problema. We got your back, Mr. Lee.
You're the man, big guy. You're the man.
Do your job next time.
I am doing my job.
You want to get your butt kicked again?
Not
really.
Okay, and keep on cleaning.
You're not the boss of me. Keep it up and I'm telling Mom.
Sorry if I messed our hip hop material. Sorry if I'm selling a bit of everything. But my dreams have come true because it's set too high. I'm in the clouds. If I fall off, I might just die. So my only chance to live is to make this rhyme. To make this song a hit, but I can sell out my ideals.
What's your name? Hey, where are you going?
He'll be back.
Charlie, who's that kid?
No, that's our local troublemaker. Kids call him Psycho.
Psycho?
Yeah. They say he likes to beat up kids.
Does he have any friends?
Not that I know of. And he never talks.
I just wanted to fit in.
You broke your mother's heart.
Everybody at that tournament had uniforms except for us.
It's not that uniform that's gonna make you a winner, Wyatt.
Yeah, well, I didn't want them laughing at me.
Would you rather have kids laugh at you or go to jail for doing something so stupid?
Who cares?
Wyatt, there are two kinds of people in the world. Either you're a problem maker or you're a problem solver.
If my dad was alive, things would be different.
Look, I understand your situation. But you still gotta give me your word that you will never steal again. Your word, Wyatt.
Why are you doing this?
Doing what?
I'm not stupid, you know.
What are you talking about?
I overheard you on the phone. So don't pretend like you care for us when you really don't.
Jimmy Lee to see Mr. Hirschfeld?
Sure, take a seat. He'll be with you in one moment.
Great, thank you.
Mr. Hirschfeld?
Yes, Gigi, what is it?
There's a Mr. Lee here to see you.
Okay, tell him I'll be with him in just a little bit.
Well, as I was saying, I'm going to have my attorney draft up a new contract. We're going to extend your sponsorship another 3 years.
Ah, that's fantastic. Thank you, Mr. Hirschfeld.
Both of you.
And I'm sorry, I didn't mean to eavesdrop, but your appointment with Mr. Lee, that's not with Jimmy Lee by any chance, is it?
Yes, it is. Why do you know him?
I'm afraid that I do, and, well, quite frankly, he's bad news.
How so?
Well, I've known him for a number of years. He's washed up as a fighter. But word on the street is that he's been working at a local community center, and he's been using the kids as an excuse to make extra money. I mean, you do what you want, obviously, but if I were you, I'd be very careful about getting involved with him.
I'll tell you what, why don't you guys have some water? I want my captain hydrated while I go have a little conversation with Mr. Lee.
All right.
Why did you say that about Mr. Lee?
In order to win, you use every weapon at your disposal.
Even if it's not the truth?
Every weapon.
Gigi?
Yes, Mr. Hirschfeld?
Could you please send in Mr. Lee? Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Herschel.
Ah, Mr. Lee, come in. Sit down.
Thank you. And thank you for seeing me on such a short notice.
Absolutely. So, how can I help?
Well, I came here because I coach a bunch of kids at the community center. But because of the budget cuts, we're having a difficult time supporting them. So I was wondering if you would have any interest in supporting us.
I assume you have some experience in tournament competition?
Yes, sir, I do. In fact, I was a former MMA champion for 3 consecutive years.
Really?
Yes, sir.
And now you're down at the community center coaching kids in karate.
Well, karate, taekwondo, kung fu, martial arts, yes.
All right, look, the thing that I don't really get, why is an MMA champ like yourself working down at the community center coaching kids?
It's temporary.
It's temporary?
Yes, until I get my next big fight.
So what I heard about you is true.
I'm sorry?
See, I give you the money, you get your next big fight, you leave all those kids high and dry. Sorry, we're not going to do that.
Mr. Hirschfeld.
No. Our company's overextended right now, and we can't help out.
Mr. Hirschfeld.
No.
I'm not asking you for a lot of money. These kids, they're really good kids.
I'm sure they are.
That you could just give them a chance.
Maybe some other time.
I understand. I should be going.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Your next big fight.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lee. Our company's not in a position to sponsor you at this time.
Thank you, baby.
Boy, you look like you had one heck of a day.
That noticeable, huh?
Jimmy, I've never seen you like this. What's the matter?
You really want to listen?
Try me.
Well, I need to find a sponsor for Charlie's kids, but everybody turned me down.
Maybe you're asking the wrong people.
Maybe you're right, but I'm running out of options, Big Mama.
Well, how much do you need, baby?
I mean, about $2,000-$3,000.
Put me in for two.
Wait a minute, Big Mama, no.
I know it's not a lot, but that's all I have in my savings.
I can't take your last savings.
Jimmy, if I had more, I'd give it to you.
I don't know what to say, Big Mama.
Well, I do something nice for you, and you do something nice for me.
And what's that?
You'll see.
Where is he? He said he'll be here.
Well, then he will be here.
Your coach?
I've never seen him in my life.
Nope. No way.
We could have won that match.
How could he do that to us?
So embarrassing.
Yeah, so embarrassing.
Will you stop repeating everything I say?
Will you stop repeating everything I say?
Does this mean we get free hot dogs?
Shut up!
Okay, kids. I could explain. But first, I want you to close your eyes.
What? Another surprise?
Yeah, maybe he'll turn into a hamburger this time.
Come on, guys. Just close your eyes. Open your eyes. This is for you. This is for you. This is for you. This is for you.
Sweet!
I'm the Vision.
Sean, I don't think that goes there.
You guys, meet your new sponsor. Big Mama?
Hello, kids. My name is Alice, but you can call me Big Mama. And it is my pleasure meeting you all.
Hi, Big Mama.
I knew it. You gotta be kidding me.
Coach? Really?
Coach, we can't wear this.
Yeah, we can't wear this.
Why?
Yeah, Alex, why not?
Dude, don't you get it? They're gonna call us weenies.
Not me. What's a weenie?
Wyatt, how many times do I have to tell you? It's not the uniform that's gonna make us win or lose.
This is messed up.
Look. This is what's handed to us. Either we compete with uniforms or we don't. Now, I know you kids don't think this is the coolest thing in the world, but we have to make the best with what we got. And that's why we're the underdogs. From now on, we take everything that is negative in our lives and let's do something positive with it.
Are you with me or not?
Not.
Shut up, Wyatt. Dang.
Excuse me, Jimmy, but may I speak?
By all means.
Privately? You kids, listen up. What you just did to Jimmy was not only unfair, but mighty disrespectful. Come on, think about it. Do you think a professional champ like him dressing up like a hot dog was easy? All these people laughing at him? He went to hundreds of companies when he didn't have to. I know I wouldn't, but he still did. And do you know why? Because no one wanted to sponsor you. Everybody turned you guys down. And if it wasn't for Jimmy, I wouldn't sponsor you either. So, you kids either shape up or we can just go home right now. You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah, Big Mama.
Darth Vader, can you please go and get Jimmy back for me now?
Well?
I'm in.
Me too. I'm with you, Coach.
I'm not quitting, Coach.
Only if we get free hot dogs.
I think I can manage that.
Yes. Anybody else?
I guess so.
All right. This is good. From now on, what are we?
Weenies!
See? I told you.
It's underdog, you dummy. Oh, pickles.
Once again, who are we?
Underdog.
Who are we?
Underdog.
Who are we?
Underdog.
Rashid has a bad temper, but he loves this stuff. He watches every kung fu movie that comes out. So my husband and I just thought this could be a good place for him to learn some discipline.
Mrs. Shabazz, you brought him to the right place.
That's good news. Thank you.
Rashid, you're gonna get started tomorrow morning, okay?
All right, well, we'll be going now. Thank you.
Nice talking to you, Rashid.
Ooh.
That boy doesn't need karate, he needs therapy.
Hey, Charlie, I was that kid, remember? And I've always been thankful that you never gave up.
That means you're staying for good, right?
I didn't say that. What I said was I was thankful. Charlie, I gotta get you some hearing aids because you're beginning to hear things. I'll talk to you later, Charlie. When you were born, you did not have a choice to be black, brown, white, or yellow. You also didn't have a choice to be born rich or poor. And you certainly don't have a choice of what people think of you. But that's okay, because the most important choice you have is what you think of yourselves. And that's something no one can take away from you. So if you had a choice between being a winner or a loser, then choose to be a winner. Hey.
Hi.
You look very nice.
I hope I'm not bothering you.
No, not at all. What's up?
Well, I want to thank you for everything you've done for Alex and Sean. You know, they've really taken liking to you.
They're great kids. And anybody would have done the same.
Well, I doubt that. Anyway, listen. I was wrong about you. I just wanted to apologize.
It's okay. If I was in your shoes, I wouldn't pay $40 to a guy who calls himself a lightning bolt.
I better be going.
Hey, Valerie.
Yeah?
Would you like to, never mind.
I'd love to.
Strong arm!
Concentrate, Raymond. Strong eyes.
Hooray! Raymond. Not with your mouth. You're supposed to punch it. Okay, you guys. Go wash up. Don't forget to practice strong eyes.
What? Who am I? I'm your worst nightmare. I am Farticus Maximus, and you're going down. Ah!
Zuko, and now we have the results of the All-City Junior Nationals. The winner of this event will have a chance to go up against our reigning champions, the Beverly Hills Scorpions team. And now, the winner is... the Mid-City Underdogs! The Mid-City Underdogs!
We're gonna celebrate! Yeah! Well,
congratulations, Jimmy. Your weenies made it in.
There, you mean the underdog?
Whatever. They don't stand a chance against my scorpions. They don't have what it takes.
You think so, huh?
One could say they can't cut the mustard.
I'm gonna go.
Oh.
Aren't you happy for them?
I am. But you know what? They needed so much energy. They just lacked, Charlie, what's that word?
Chutzpah.
Chutzpah, that's what we did. And their musical form was totally off. And you know, in order for us to beat Barrett's team, we're gonna need a new choreographer.
I think I can help you with that. If you're interested, that is.
Why are we here?
To learn?
Learn to be what? A wuss?
Bonjour. Bienvenidos.
Welcome.
I know what you boys are thinking. But dance, like martial arts, is all about rhythm. Everything from ballet to hip-hop has a different rhythm.
Just kill me now.
Everyone ready?
Dude, that workout today was insane.
Hey, guys, you're not gonna believe this.
What?
My little sister's in this ballet class, and guess who else is in it?
Who?
The weenies.
The weenies?
Let's get them. I have a plan.
They are.
Who
came up with this? Oh, yeah, that was me. Doesn't even
know what I'm doing. Oh, man, this is great.
Let's put it online.
Let's go.
What are you laughing at?
We're laughing at you, Twinkle Toes.
Break it up! What is going on here, huh? What's going on?
They started it!
Okay, I've had enough of you. You're suspended. Rest of you back to class, now!
Come on.
Hey, how you doing?
Emma, what's up?
You must be Rushy's older brother.
Yeah, who's asking?
I'm Jimmy, Rushy's coach.
Oh, man.
How you doing?
Good, man. He in a doghouse, y'all.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, man. Hey, man.
Why are you getting into so many fights?
I don't like to be teased.
Nobody does, Rasheen. But you can't go through life beating up on people.
It's easy for you to say. You never been teased like I have!
Rasheed, I got news for you. When I was your age, I got teased a lot.
So what did you do?
I got into a lot of fights.
So you know how I feel.
Yes, I do. But I had to learn that it takes a bigger man to know when to fight and when not to. And in order for you to do that, well, you've got to believe in yourself.
I don't know how.
Charlie once told me to remember the three R's. Well, number one, you have to learn to respect others. Number two, you have to respect yourself. And number three, you have to take responsibility of your actions. Now, you think you could do that?
Yeah.
You're gonna be all right, Rasheed. I believe in you. But next time, don't block with your face. Right? Come here, give me a hug.
Look at my nails.
That's great. Boys, how do you like your hand massage?
This is awesome.
Hey, Coach.
Yeah?
What does the Bill of Rights mean?
I know.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do.
All right, what does it mean?
It means when you get a bill at the restaurant, you check it to make sure that it's right.
Wow.
That's dumb. D-U-N, dumb.
One, two, three!
It's okay. You'll be able to do it next time. Let's practice harder, okay?
Hey, buddy. What's up?
Hi, Dad. You're coming to the tournament, right?
Oh, you bet. In fact, I'm flying in right now. You ready to kick some butt?
You know it.
Oh, you remind me of myself when I was your age. All right, good luck.
All right, Dad. Bye.
Hey, James. Clear my schedule tomorrow. We're gonna kick some butt.
Can I ask you something?
What is it?
Are you ashamed of me?
I never said that.
Then how come you never come see me compete?
Because I'm busy, son.
Oh. Okay.
Make sure you got home safely.
Oh, sweetie. Here.
Oh, no, Mom, I'm really not that cold.
No, I don't want you to catch a cold. Here, come.
There we go.
So, I got some good news.
Oh, yeah?
I got a promotion at work today.
Really?
My manager said I was one of the best workers that she has ever had.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. So you want to know how I'm going to celebrate?
Yeah.
I am taking you to the movies this weekend.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to buy you a big old bucket of popcorn, lots of fake butter, and
Mom.
Milk duds.
Mom,
and.
I'm over that. All right, we can just bring popcorn from home. Besides, I was just as good as theirs anyway.
Yeah. You think so?
And, I've been thinking. I don't want to be a problem maker anymore. And when I grow up, I'm going to be really successful. And I'm going to take really good care of you.
And I want to be the best mom that I can be.
I love you.
Oh, baby. I love you.
Are you serious? A title fight.
I know, it's great. One of their fighters got sick and I slipped you right in there. $200,000. They want to fly you out here tonight. First class, everything.
Tonight?
Yes, I already booked your ticket. And there's a limo on the way to get you.
No, wait a minute. My kid's tournament is tomorrow.
It's $200,000, Jimmy. You could buy him a bunch of toys. Buddy, we are back in the game. Listen, if you don't fight tomorrow, your career is over.
Yeah, I know.
Jimmy, this is your last chance. Don't blow it.
Guys, I just wanted to say goodbye before I leave.
It's not fair.
Sean, I'm sorry.
Are you coming back?
No.
Oh, great. So you're just gonna walk out on us?
Raymond, I don't have a choice.
You have a choice? Everybody has a choice. You taught us that.
Wyatt? Ricky? Machine. Charlie?
Can't blame them. They love you.
Ready for you to sign.
Here we go.
Here we go, buddy.
Changed my mind. Gino, I can't do it.
One second. Stop. Wait a minute. Jimmy, what are you doing?
I can't do this anymore, Gino.
What are you talking about?
I can't do this anymore.
It's those kids.
They got to you, didn't they?
It's where I belong.
But what about the money, Jimmy?
I know we need the money.
Yeah.
But I've been chasing the wrong thing all my life. And finally, I know what I want.
Well, I wish I had your courage.
You mean that?
No. Good luck to you out there.
A.K.A. Big Man Bosco. Ladies and gentlemen, an event of this size could not happen without the support of our sponsors, Catapult Footwear, the Max Cure Pediatric Cancer Foundation, Yowza, go to getyowza.com. Without this sponsor, we couldn't have made this event happen. Thank you, Century Martial Arts. To my right, the undefeated title holder of the All-City Junior National Championships for three consecutive years. Let's hear it for the Beverly Hills Scorpions. And to my left, the Mid-City Underdog. May the best team win. Here we go.
There is no team greater than you. Your only objective is to destroy everything that stands in the way of victory. You must not only defeat your opponent, but you must also break them mentally and physically.
Okay, let's circle up.
He came!
Shaw! Shaw! Oh, Shaw! Hey, guys. Am I too late?
No!
You're never too late, folks. Okay, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The first match of the day between Andrew representing the Scorpions and Wyatt representing the Underdog.
Watch it.
And here we go again. Both fighters looking for an opening.
You could do it. Right. You could take him.
Andrew kicks and misses. Wyatt with a jumping spin roundhouse kick. Point for the midsection. Andrew goes down. Boy, these two fighters are really going at it today. So far, Scorpions are in the lead. Underdogs behind in points, trying to catch up. Both teams sizing each other up.
You were awesome, Wyatt.
I have no excuses. He was better than me. It was my bad.
It's come a long way, Wyatt. And I'm proud of you.
And the Scorpions take the first match. Going to the scoreboard, Scorpions 10, Underdog 6. It's now Cameron of the Scorpions against Ricky of the Underdogs getting ready to fight. Referee gives the signal. The battle is on. Both fighters exchanging kicks. Spinning roundhouse kick and connects. A point. Whoa. A powerful kick to Ricky, knocking him down and getting points for the Scorpion. Attacks. Letitia counters, misses, moving, waiting for an opening. Scorpion. Looks like Raymond from the Underdogs team is on the run. Oh boy, this looks like a train wreck waiting to happen. Century. Now the match is between Scorpions Jake and Little Sean from Underdog.
Sean's in trouble.
Yeah.
Jake attacks. Oh, this doesn't look good.
Pass this down to your coach, all right?
Little Sean could sure use a miracle right now.
My pillow.
Come on, Sean. Oh, boy, this next match is going to be interesting. Alex's opponent is a foot taller than he is.
What's the matter?
He's so much bigger than I am. He's going to kill me.
Alex, just keep looking at him, all right? Remember David and Goliath?
Yeah.
All right, so who was bigger?
Goliath.
Who won?
David.
Yeah, so have the courage of David, all right? Use your speed and your smarts. Okay, and remember, the bigger they are,
the harder they fall.
Yeah.
Well, get him, Alex! Get him,
Alex! Okay, here we go. Scorpions on the offensive. Alex trying to evade those powerful kicks. Alex trying to find an opening. The Scorpion fighter is relentless, not giving Alex an opening. Alex shuffling his feet side to side, looking for an opening.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Alex lands a huge kick, taking the giant down. Did you see that kick? That was like poetry in motion.
This kid, Rashid, he stutters and he's got a bad temper. Piss him off and get him disqualified.
Dad, I can take him.
Do as I say. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here we go. Scorpions team captain Eric and Underdog Rashid.
Come on, act.
Come on, Pavaz.
Nope.
No, nice try. I bet your grandma hits harder than you.
You're gonna get disqualified. Be careful.
Think of your team, Rashid. Think of yourself.
Rashid, confidence. Believe in yourself. Now take your turn, Rashid.
Hey, come on, LeBron. It's all you, man.
Come on.
What are you doing, man? Ow!
so unorthodox. Come on, bro. You, man.
Look at that. You see that? That's a tie. When it's not, it's a win. You let him beat you. Him. He stinks, which means you suck. Get out of here.
I'm sorry. What? Can I please direct your attention to our scoreboard? This never happens. Look at the score. You've got the Beverly Hills Scorpions 22. Mid-City Underdogs 22. We have a tie, ladies and gentlemen, which means that our competition will be decided with the musical form competition.
And now, introducing the musical form judges, Master Richard Norton, Master Dawn the Dragon Wilson, Master Danny Innocento, Master Benny Yorkide, Master John Chomp.
First, performing their extreme musical form, please give a warm round of applause to the undefeated All-City Junior National Champions, the Beverly Hills Scorpions! Scorpions 71, Mid-City Underdogs 22. So let's give a big, warm round of applause for our challengers, the Mid-City Underdogs. Here they are.
Insurance. Squirt that water in the socket.
Dad, I'm not going to do that.
Squirt some water in the socket.
No.
What'd you say?
Hurt me, Dad.
Hey, I didn't get us into this position. You did. Now squirt some water in the socket.
Guys, I have bad news.
What's wrong, Coach?
The CD is broken.
How are we supposed to do the form without the music?
This is jacked up.
Yeah, how?
With our hearts.
That doesn't make sense.
I want you to listen to the music and feel the music in your hearts. We are the underdogs. This is what's handed to us. But always remember our motto, to take everything that's negative in our lives
and turn it into something positive.
That's right. Now I want you to go out there, close your eyes, and listen for my beats. You got that? Okay.
Can somebody please turn on the lights? I need lights. I can't do an event. Hi! Ray Bosco, and apparently you see the lights are back on. It's all good. Now let's continue our musical forms competition. Thank you, honey.
Charlie, I need your shoes.
Okay, for what?
I don't have time to explain right now. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, Charlie.
Hold your breath. Those are my new ones.
We'll be right back.
First judge, a 10. Second judge, a 10. Third judge, a 10. Fourth judge, a 10. And the final judge, hey!
Call you mom from now on.
Yeah. I like that very much. I'm so proud of you. Ah, come here.
You guys were awesome.
Yeah, you have some pretty sick moves.
That was mean, man.
Friends?
Friends.
Mr. Hirschfeld, aren't you proud of me? I mean, proud of us, obviously.
Proud of the team? Yes.
You?
No. It's people like you that give this sport a bad name. So as of today, right now, we are through.
No buts,
Barrett. James, unfriend him and block him from my Facebook.
We'll be right back.